So let us discuss the next article, effect of diode characteristics on clamping voltage from unity to non-linear wave shaping of pulse and digital circuit. What is this article? Effect of diode characteristics on clamping voltage. Let us see how these diode characteristics influence the clamping voltage. So first, for this let us consider negative clamper circuit. So as you know that the negative clamper circuit consisting of the source resistance RS, for example, say let us say source resistance RS C, and the diode of this negative clamper will be in this direction, and we place a shunt resistor R across the diode. So this is the negative clamper circuit. So therefore Vs is the input to the circuit, V0 is the output across the circuit. So let us assume the source resistance is equal to 0. For example, say the source resistance is equal to 0. For this circuit, let us say we are applying a square wave input. Like this. Say the high level is say V dash, the low level is say V double dash, and let us the difference between V dash and V double dash is say V, capital V, peak to peak voltage is say capital V. So this is the input we give to the circuit. So let us see. So let us see the first one, when the input is at high level, so that is what we are considering. So as explained, what is the condition of the diode? The diode is forward biased. So therefore, what the diode is forward biased. So that is what you have to read, right? The capacitor charges during this interval. So these are the common points for clamping circuit theorem and other conditions also. The capacitor charges during this interval. So I am drawing a circuit like this. Say this is the capacitor. See how you draw the circuit. Just place the diode as it is. So the input is V dash. Let us say the voltage across capacitor is say Vc. Let us say, since the diode is forward biased, let us say if the voltage across this diode is say Vcl, and the current flowing through this diode when it is on condition is say Icl. So these are the important points. So this is the output voltage. So however R is there, even though the R is there, the output voltage is equal to Vcl. So that is what you have to observe. So here what you have to understand is that here Vcl is equal to voltage across the diode, the first point, voltage across the diode, and Icl, what is Icl here? Icl is the current through the diode. So what is output voltage? Nearly equal to Vcl. So therefore from VI characteristics of the diode, so what is the equation? Equation we know that, so I am writing it separately here. The diode current I is equal to what is I naught reverse saturation current into e power V by eta Vt minus 1. So since this factor is very very large, we can approximately write it as e power V by eta Vt. Use this formula. This is a well-known formula, voltage and current relations of diode, where I is the current through the diode, V is the voltage across diode. So as you know that eta is equal to 1 for germanium and 2 for silicon. And what is Vt? Vt is equal to T by 11600. These are the standard values you have to remember. At 300 Kelvin, at room temperature, 27 degrees or 370 Kelvin, So VT comes out as 26 millivolts. Whenever diode comes into mind, so you have to remember these equations. So therefore, what is the current now? The current in the circuit is now ICL, since the diode is, the current through the diode is ICL. So that is approximately equal to I0 is the reverse saturation current, and E power, what is the voltage across the diode? VCL by eta VT. So this is the charging current of the capacitor. I write it as, this is the charging current of capacitor. So this is what you have to write clearly. So this is the charging current of the capacitor, or the current flowing from the diode. In other way, you can say like this. So say this is the equation 1. For example, say equation 1. So now, so what is the voltage across capacitor now? Simply V dash minus VCL is the voltage across capacitor. Voltage across capacitor is simply V dash minus VCL is the voltage across capacitor. So therefore, voltage across capacitor, voltage across capacitor. So what is the voltage across capacitor? Simply, so VC is equal to V dash minus VCL. So this is the another important relation. So what we have just to find out the charging current equation. Now let us take the second case. What is the second case? When the input is at low level, so that is Vs is equal to V double dash. So what is the status of the diode? The diode is off. So the diode is off in the circuit. What happens to the capacitor? The capacitor discharges. Remember that these are all the common points. The capacitor discharges. So let us draw the circuit. So therefore, I am drawing the capacitor. This is the capacitor. So the diode is off. It comes out. It will go out of the circuit. So therefore, the resistor R here. So what is the input here? The input is V double dash. The voltage across capacitor is say VC. Let us say the discharging current in the circuit is say I. So therefore, let us say the voltage across resistor. So therefore, the voltage across resistor is say VR. Therefore, what we can write here is that the voltage across the resistor, under this case, very simple, we can write it as VC minus V double dash. The voltage across resistor is written as VC minus V double dash. Remember that VC minus V double dash. We have to write like this. VC minus V double dash is nothing but as voltage across this resistor. So, but what is VC we get? So, VC earlier we get is during the charging period, what is the capacitor voltage? V dash minus VCL. So just to substitute V dash minus VCL here. So V dash minus VCL minus V double dash. So what is V dash minus V double dash? It is the peak to peak voltage of the input. So that is V we have taken. So VCL is the voltage across the diode, which is very, very small. So generally the peak to peak voltage of the, so if input is very high when compared with the clamping voltage VCL, so VCL is generally 0.5 or 0.6. So therefore, this is approximately equal to V. So therefore, what is the voltage across resistor? The voltage across resistor is approximately V. So now what we can write is that the discharging current is I is equal to, what is the discharging current? VR by R. So VR by R. But what is VR? VR be approximately equal to peak voltage. So that is R. So let us say this as equation 2. So therefore, under steady state condition, the charging current is equal to discharging current. So under steady state current, what is the charging current is always equal to discharging current. So what is the charging current? So of the capacitor, simply I naught into, so E power VCL by eta VT. So this is the charging current. What is the discharging current? V by R. So take V0 to the right side, sorry, I0 reverse saturation current to the right side. So therefore, E power VCL by eta VT. So that is equal to V by I naught into R. So take natural logarithm on both sides. We get VCL is equal to eta VT into natural logarithm of V by I0 into R. So this is also written as, this term is written as log A minus log B, log V minus log I0 into R. So let us differentiate this equation, differentiating above equation. So left side we write it as DVCL, change in the clamping voltage. This is taken as change in the clamping voltage. So that is equal to eta VT. So the differentiation of log V is 1 by V. And if you differentiate V again, it will come out as dV by V. So the differentiation of constant is 0. So therefore, this is the very, very important equation which we have to prove in the examination. This is the equation which we have to prove in the examination. This gives the dependence of the clamping voltage on the change in the input voltage. So this relation gives change in clamping voltage to the change in the input voltage. So this relation gives change in clamping voltage to change in input voltage. So this is the important equation we have to derive. So that means if you change the input voltage, the clamping voltage also changes. So this should not be the case. If you change the input voltage, the clamping voltage should remain the same. So therefore, for this purpose, so what we do is that, so even if you increase the input peak to peak voltage, the clamping voltage should remain the same. So therefore, but according to this relation, if you change the input voltage, the clamping voltage changes. So therefore, for this purpose, we use the biased clamper circuit, so which we make slight change in the circuit. So that means, so this is our circuit, capacitor. So this is our diode, So therefore, what we will do is that, so just instead of resistor here, just place the resistor here and give the supply VCC to here. So this is the input voltage, say VS. So this is the capacitor, this is the output voltage. Let us say RS. RS is the source resistance. So this circuit ensures that, this circuit ensures the stability of clamping voltage even input voltage changes. So this circuit will ensure the stability in the clamping voltage even the input voltage changes. So this is what you have to mention. This is the modified circuit which keeps the clamping voltage stable even though the input voltage changes. So therefore, let us write the ICL, the charging current ICL in this case is given by 2VCC plus V by R. So because of this ICL, because of this circuit, ICL charging current will become like this. Under the same equation, the clamping voltage, the change in the clamping voltage, which is given by eta VT into dV by just replace 2VCC plus V. So this is what you have to mention about this very, very simple article in the examination, that is effect of diode characteristics on the clamping voltage. Thank you.